Tetanus, a potentially deadly bacterial infection, is a formidable adversary that can invade the body through even the tiniest of wounds. This silent threat, caused by the bacterium Clostridium tetani commonly found in soil, dust, and manure, lurks in the shadows, waiting for an opportunity to strike the unprepared man that takes it for granted. However, survival from this silent killer bacterial isn't merely a matter of chance, it's a meticulous dance between preparedness and swift medical intervention. Understanding the tetanus is the first step to survival. Tetanus spores enter the body through cuts, puncture wounds, burns, or any injury where the skin has breached even a tiny puncture or a seemingly insignificant cut. Once inside, these spores release a powerful toxin that affects the nervous system, leading to painful muscle contractions, commonly known as lockjaw. As the infection progresses, muscles throughout the body may seize, causing breathing difficulties and potentially fatal complications. The outcome of those who survive also depends on how early you take the right action. While some will survive without any serious complications, some may require physical therapy to regain muscle strength and function, while managing lingering complications such as respiratory issues or muscle stiffness. To survive this deadly bacterial called tetanus, the first step is vigilance. Awareness of the wound's severity and potential exposure to the bacterium is paramount. Any injury, no matter how small, demands attention. Although nobody wants to get injured, yet accidents happen and wounds are inevitable. Even minor cuts or scrapes can become gateways for tetanus if not properly cared for. To minimize risks, 1. Cleanse wounds thoroughly. Immediately cleanse any injury with soap and water to remove dirt and bacteria. 2. Apply antiseptic. Use an antiseptic solution like hydrogen peroxide or rubbing alcohol to further disinfect the wound. 3. Seek medical attention. For deep or dirty wounds, consult a healthcare professional to evaluate the risk of tetanus infection. The first crucial defense is vaccination. The administration of the tetanus vaccine offers a robust protection against tetanus. Timely booster shots of the tetanus vaccine further fortify this protection, ensuring a prolonged defense against tetanus. Should tetanus infection become a concern, recognizing the symptoms becomes a lifeline. Early signs include muscle stiffness, particularly in the jaw, we call this lockjaw, difficulty swallowing, muscle spasms, and fever. Immediate medical attention is imperative upon suspecting tetanus. Treatment for tetanus involves hospitalization in an intensive care setting. Supportive care aims to manage symptoms and prevent complications. This includes wound care, medication to control muscle spasms, and sometimes the use of tetanus immune globulin, a potent agent that neutralizes the toxin when the body's own defenses prove insufficient to neutralize the toxins. Although prevention is the most important thing to do, but in the unfortunate event of suspicious tetanus exposure, do the following. 1. Run to get immediate medical help. Seek medical care without delay upon suspecting tetanus, as early intervention enhances chances of recovery and survival. At this point, the race for survival is now a race against time. 2. Follow your doctor's antibiotics prescription. Doctors may administer antibiotics like metronidazole to eradicate the bacteria and halt toxin production. 3. Get hospital supportive care. Hospitalization ensures monitoring and supportive measures to manage symptoms and prevent the complications. The tetanus bacterial takes its time, incubating in the body before launching its onslaught. Hence, monitoring for symptoms becomes crucial. The telltale signs of tetanus, stiffness in muscles, difficulty swallowing, and painful spasms, should never be disregarded. Swift action in response to these warning signs could mean the difference between survival and death. Surviving tetanus depends largely on swift medical intervention. Treatment for tetanus encompasses a multidimensional approach. Antitoxin therapy works to neutralize the toxin, while medications alleviate symptoms and manage muscle spasms. Additionally, managing muscle spasms and providing respiratory support through mechanical ventilation are crucial measures in the fight for survival. Recovery from tetanus is a slow and arduous journey. The severity of the infection and the promptness of medical care significantly influence the prognosis. Rehabilitation may encompass physical therapy to regain muscle strength and function, while managing lingering complications such as respiratory issues or muscle stiffness. Furthermore, tetanus is not a foe to be taken lightly. It demands respect and diligence. For those dwelling in environments with potential tetanus hazard like construction sites, farms, or areas with abundant in rust and soil, extra precautions are mandatory. Protective gear, such as gloves and sturdy footwear, serves as a barrier between oneself and the lurking danger. If your work puts you at risk, get vaccinated. Tetanus vaccine is readily available worldwide. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. If you find value in this video, kindly subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified anytime we release a new video. Note that knowledge is advancing by the day, and we will like to always post an update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. You are watching Zoom Hospital Channel and listening to Work of Dr. Kayode.